back. And you know what time it is? It's Pepe Billete, that's how to get pinga! Marihuana para la pinga, porque dejé el trailer a la canción ir muy larga. Y qué vuelta, mi gente, qué volá. Aquí estamos en The Feliz Día de los Marihuaneros para la pinga. That's right, and as you can tell, I don't know if you were able to notice right away, but I'm doing the fucking show by myself today. Because La Lily, si lo puedes creer, you know, if you look at our show description today, today the show is all about marijuana. We're talking about marijuana legislation. We're talking about the evolution of marijuana. We're talking about marijuana in popular culture. And we are talking about why you shouldn't be a fucking pussy when you get sick. Porque eso es lo que le pasó a la Lily hoy. Hoy la Lily me llamó, dice, Pepe, I'm not feeling too good. Y yo, bueno, coño, qué rico, qué bueno. Mira, caga, que eso se te quita y ven a trabajar, que la cosa está de pinga. So she came to work. And then she fucking passed out. Tremendo show. Ay, baby, I feel so saint. Blah, blah. Fue al baño. Vomitó como una coma pinga. Le dije, chica, ¿pero qué te pasa a ti? ¿Tú tomaste? ¿Cogiste hangover anoche? ¿Qué te pasa? No, baby, I don't feel good. Y después, con tremendo show, se acostó ahí en el sofá. And she fell asleep. And then she says, oh, my God, did I pass out? Ay, come mierda, no, te quedaste dormida, que pinga, pasado ni pasado, tú no te caíste y no diste en la cabeza ni un carajo. You just fell asleep, you lazy shit, you've been asleep for an hour, that's not passing out. Coño. Y pues dice, no, I need to go to urgent care. So hace como a las 2 de la tarde, para que tú veas, vaya, que te vaya de pinga, porque lo que es tener, vaya, se fue para el urgent care a las 2 de la tarde y no ha regresado. Y la llamé y dice, chica, ¿qué te pasa? No, no, just eso, con tremendo fucking drama. No, no, I saw the nurse, and now I'm waiting to see the doctor, que le pinga. Yo, mija, lo que tú tienes es un peo atravesado. No me resingues la vida. No me jodas tú, que pinga te pasa a ti. What happened to you? No, I don't feel good, I feel nauseous. No me diga. And that's really a reason to go to the urgent care. Maybe it's me, people. Maybe it's me, man. I don't know. Maybe it's my problem. Pero yo no sé si ustedes son como yo, but I was brought up a little bit different. Yo no voy al hospital. Vaya, que no, yo me tengo que estar muriendo para la pinga. La última vez que yo fui a un hospital, me estaba dando un infarto de un trastazo que me di, ¿ok? De mucho trastazo que me di en una noche, ¿ok? Porque no estaba cortado muy bien el perico, estaba muy clean. Y imagínate, se me fue la mano y para la pinga. Y yo, para eso, imagínate tú, que para esa mierda, ¿ok? Para eso... ¿Qué pinga? Yo no fui al hospital ni un carajo porque esa era pussy, ¿ok? Eso, para que tú veas cómo son las cosas. Fue la jeva que estaba conmigo en ese entonces. Me dijo, oye, tienes la presión a 1000 porque esa cara roja como un tomate y ese corazón que tú tienes así, dando palpitaciones, tú tienes que ir para el hospital. Y yo, no, mija, es que me paraste la pinga, lo que tengo es ganas de cingarla. And she tricked me and got me in the car thinking that we were going to a hotel room, and she ended up taking me to the fucking the Mount Sinai. A ver, ¿quién me habla ahí? You're live on the air. Yo. Espérate, let me join you. Espérate. I don't even know who this is, but shut up. Hold on. Let me join you. Uy, el pinga. Ño de pinga. Cheers, mi socio. ¿Quién me habla ahí?
Happy 420, buddy. It's Holy Smokes.
No, it's not. It's Nino from Holy Smokes, but that's okay. ¿Qué vuelta, sucio? ¿Cómo está la cosa? ¿Cómo está la cosa por allá? Tremendo parada. Are you having a parade in front of the Holy Smokes today?
Okay. Aquí con nota, con todos los marihuaneros de Pepper Pot.
Muy bien hecho, muy bien hecho. Round of applause for you. Está bien hecho eso. Oye, ¿y qué? How's business been today, man?
It's been amazing, like always, because the Pepe Billete listeners always support Holy Smokes and Pembroke Park.
Tuviste que rico ese. Tuviste que effective. Now that you are a business owner, that you're doing sponsorship, would you see how effective it is to advertise with me, Singao? Remember when we were on Sirius FM? Sirius XM, and you were going, bueno, Pepe, tú sabes que tienes que hacer unos promos que son un poquito más lively. Como decir, oye, si ustedes quieren que... ¿Te acuerdas cuando tú me decías esa cosa?
I would say that. Maybe Lily would say that. ¿Y qué le pasó a la Lily? ¿Está enferma la muy cara?
La Lily tiene... Yo no sé qué pinga tiene la Lily, pero fue para el urgent care con un... Vaya, de pinga. You know.
And that's bullshit. She took the day off to go smoke out of the bong, bro.
Nah, ¿tú crees que
you?
Yo soy come mierda? Si ni pinga. Si yo, yo llamé el courier mío de... ¿Tú sabes el courier? Que yo uso aquí a recoger todos los cheques y toda esa pinga. Y le dije, oye, socio, mira, te voy a pagar el resto del día. Aquí tienes 100 cañas. Quédate con la come mierda esta, ¿ok? Y and make sure that she gets to and from where she needs to be. Ella se pensaba que, ay, baby, you taking care of me. Thank you for not making me call Uber. Ni pinga. Eso es lo que era un security guard que yo tenía ahí a ella para pa pirarle el ojo, para que no vaya para allá, para pa, pa el brico, vaya a gozar el bollo hoy en 420, que yo no soy come mierda ni nací ayer.
Ay, pero no jodas. I guarantee you she smoked out your career. And now, está con el courier, los dos fumados para la pinga en brico, jodiendo.
Nah, yo, tú no sabes que yo tengo el iPhone que ella tiene, yo lo pago y tengo de track my iPhone. ¿Qué pinga? ¿Tú crees que viejo, pero tú no estás arriba de la tecnología y tú naciste aquí?
Cojones, pero tú estás muy preocupado and following and way too much on technology. On
that's right.
Esto vi con tremenda nota, tranquilo, haciendo show, hablando mierda.
Bueno, mi socio,
te
voy a...
Pero, la Lili, te vaya a fumar.
Nah, pero qué pinga, y le voy a pagar el día yo. Si te estoy pagando Obamacare a esa muchachita y le estoy pagando el día y que va... Coño, está bien que le tenga que tenga un problema con el culo, está bien que se lo vaya a chequear con el culoloscopy, lo que se vaya a hacer, lo que... Pero coño, que no me venga a coger de una mierda, que yo como mierda no tengo un pelo. Oye, ¿y qué tú estás fumando?
Ay,
¿y qué tú estás fumando por allá, mi socio? ¿Qué tú estás metiéndole ahí? A ver, porque you know
that
you.
Dang shit.
Ah, está bien, está bien, está bien. It's good shit, man. When you gonna send me over here a volcano, man?
A volcano, I'll ship it for you today. Ni te preocupes. Bueno, no sé, con la nota I think I'm gonna make it to UPS.
¿Tú no crees que vas a hacerle a llegar al UPS?
Nah, not today.
Bueno, ¿por qué
not
no lo traes? ¿Por qué no lo traes tú special delivery entonces, viejo?
I'm too busy selling water pipes for the 20% off on all glass. Holy smokes.
Yeah, and you got to mention Pepe Billete. Don't forget that shit, man. Manda, pinga, ¿quién está? Espérate, viejo. Oye, Nino, te quiero y me quedo corto. Espérate, mi gente, que están tocando aquí el studio door. Y tengo que mandar a alguien para la pinga. Hold on. ¡Ay, por tu madre! ¡Me cago en 10! Aquí llegó la dramática pinga esta tocando la puerta. Ok, perdona, ya como pueden oír yo... No, escucha, escucha, escucha. Listen to her. Listen to her. Oye, ¿you okay? Oye, vomita, niña, olvídate de eso. Don't worry about it. Bueno, me estaban tocando la puerta. And like you know, I mean, if you've been an avid listener to my show, you know that... we've had problems here with people, the police knocking on the studio door and me having to explain shit because this is the fucking Pepe Billete show. Imagínate, there's always a fucking surprise. Pero esta sorpresita hoy fue fenomenal. Llegó la Lily only 10 minutes into the show. Pero llegó con tremendo drama porque ya tenía una cara de miseria la niña y está sentada aquí. Ahí está sentada con los ojos cerrados, con tremendo, like Scarlett O'Hara. Parece la Scarlett O'Hara. Lily. 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 Lily, why don't you get on the mic and talk to our fans? You have people asking about you. Mira, aquí tienen la gente. Aquí tienes Eugenio. Oye, Pepe, qué vuelta. ¿Dónde está la Lily? We miss Lily, the ghost driver.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you good.
No.
¿Cómo te sientes, niña?
Not good.
Oh, y esa voz de tristeza.
Oh, I just threw up.
Ay, ¿pero qué tú hiciste anoche que tienes tanta vomitera, mijita?
My medication.
Oh, your medication, pero...
And I was in the Uber right now, and like, you know, I get motion sickness, so like, I just threw up.
¿Y qué le pasó al courier? ¿Qué? What happened to the courier that I had take you over there? Where did he go? Why did you take an Uber back?
Because, I don't know.
He didn't wait with you?
No.
No me resingue. que el tipo, el chamaco ese, no, no te esperó.
Why would he wait for me?
Because I gave him $150 to $100 to wait for you in the fucking parking lot till you got out.
You need to ask him to give it back to you.
Mijita, pero tú chequea, did you check in the parqueo si el balsero pinga ese no estaba en el carro oyendo música, oyendo fucking Daddy Yankee o algo ahí en el carro moviendo las caderas?
No, I didn't.
So, como pinga ese todavía se está sentado seguro ahí pensando que tú estás ahí adentro.
Call him.
Manda pinga, niña, la verdad que estás del carajo. Bad boys, what you gonna do? What you gonna smoke when Nino brings a bong for you? Coño, está bueno eso. Lily.
I can't. Why?
Really? You can't be live on the air? This is the problem. So you're going to be on the mic like con tremenda tristeza.
You opened the door. I was throwing up in a bag.
Entonces, ¿pa' qué pinga tú viniste? Mijita, ¿qué tú tienes?
Do you think I'm lying?
I don't think you're lying, mijita. I just think that you're being a little bit of a pussy.
You saw me throwing up right now.
Ay, mija, please. I throw up four times.
Man, I gotta go wash my mouth out.
I throw up four times. I got a brickle. Me cojo nota. And before I come to work, I throw up four or five times just for good measure. No, because you see what your generation is built out of? You see what you are built? You people are made, your generation of people are made out of fucking, vaya, I'm made out of felt, but you're made out of fucking tissue paper. You're fucking made out of Kleenex, man. Get the fuck out of here. Ay, me duele el estómago. Tengo ganas de cagar. Tengo que ir para urgent care. Chica, me favor. ¿Por qué no te tomas un tilo? Drink a tilo. O mira, échate Ivaporú. Okay, on your chest, a little bit of Ivaporú, and that's it. That shit will be gone in half an hour. You know what you could do? Mira, why don't you do this? Lily.
Yeah.
Where's that bag that the FedEx sent this today? Where's that that bag?
The
package. Really? You didn't pick up the package from... The really? You didn't do that? You didn't pick it up from the second? Manda, pinga, esta niña, mija, pero qué pinga, ¿pa qué pinga tú viniste a trabajar? Pásame la vida un yogur.
I ran here because I felt like
you
I was...
You ran? Yes, no, I feel you, pero what did you run here for?
Because you said I was lying, so I wanted to show
I don't
you.
Believe that you're lying. I mean, I just think... I never said you're lying.
Come in, I was going to get fired.
Oh, okay, so what you... I never said you were going to get fired. I said you were being a pussy. Yeah,
leave the
drama.
You just saw me fucking throwing up, like, right when you opened
Conveniently
the door.
Conveniently, as I was opening the door.
I was already throwing up down the hallway. That's why I was pounding on the door.
Chica, are you pregnant or some shit?
No. It's the medication. It's too high.
What's your medication? What are you taking?
None of your business.
So I mean, it's clearly it is my business if
condition.
I'm paying for it.
I have a condition.
What are you taking?
Oh, no,
are you taking opium or hydrocodone that makes you throw up so much?
It's a really strong
antibiotic. If you do, hook it up.
It's a really strong antibiotic for acne.
You're taking, really? This... De este show entero que tú has hecho hoy, tanto que te estabas muriendo, yo pensando que tú te estabas tomando fucking, I don't know what, that you overdosed on fucking Percocet or some shit. All of this bullshit has been because you took an antibiotic?
No, I took two, it's the...
Ah, te tomaste dos antibióticos and you feel a little sick?
No, not a little sick, you
¿Qué
saw...
¡Qué cosa más Oye, grande finga. Por tu madre! Are you serious, Lily?
I have a fever. I have a fever 101.
Báñate en la piscina, mijita, para que tú veas cómo se te quita esa come mierdería. Uh-huh. You have a little bit, you took a little. You think antibiotics can kill you? You think you can overdose on the antibiotics? That's just your stomach. That's like when you eat some bad sushi. That's the equivalent of what you have right now.
Talk about sushi.
Fucking, oh my God, you are made out of pussy. I mean, tissue pussy.
You know what?
I'm not even going to spend any more time on this. Because I've already spent 15 fucking minutes on you and your bullshit. And today is... No. Take a nap, absolutely. On the clock. Have a fucking ball. I'm going to sit here and... ¿Qué te pasa, mijita? ¿Qué ahora que metiste en la boca? You're a baby, you know that? You're a fucking baby.
No, I just
got it coughed up. Ay, look at that coughed up. Mijita, pero ¿qué tú tienes que hacer? What would you do, okay? If the fucking world se te estaba cayendo arriba. And what the fuck is this bullshit?
Ay,
I have a little bit of stomach ache and I gotta throw up. Mira, mijita, me haces el favor porque yo te voy a enseñar a ti bien como lo que es ser mujer. Hoy tú vas a aprender. You need to do, get up, go downstairs, okay, and pick up the package from the mail clerk.
I haven't eaten. I threw up all the food that I had.
Don't worry, you're not gonna die on the way back.
I was gonna
promise you, you'll be okay. You'll be fine. Dale. Tómate un bucho de agua, tírate un peo y dale para allá.
You don't care about me.
Of course. Ay, chica, really? Is this what this has become? Really? Why? Why?
Because
of your little bullshit? Oye, mi gente, am I wrong here? Am I the problem here?
Am I
the one that's wrong? Genital acne. Really? Genital acne.
No.
Really, you just could have said that you were taking, could you get like 4 pimples so you got to take a pill for it, really? What the fucking, what is that shit? That's some bitch shit, man. That's
why
some
is it bitch?
That's some Drake shit.
I'm trying to contain the problem before it.
By taking a pill for
a
pimples?
Fucking, that's what my dermatologist prescribed me.
Claro que también, of course he did.
No, not pimples, acne, like, because I have...
Acne, because te coge, you know what? You overuse the word acne a lot because you get 4 fucking pimples when you get your period. That's not acne, mijita. Acne is when you look like Edward James almost. And you don't look like Stand and Deliver, mijita. So te vas pa la pinga. Give me a break. You don't look like Lou Diamond Phillips.
No.
You don't look like Machete. Like Danny Trejo. If you look like Danny Trejo, I'd say, yeah, coño, take a pill. Do something. Have some surgery. But you're fine. You don't got acne. Get the fuck out of here. Am I wrong, mi gente? Mira, aquí dice Carlos que no, I'm not wrong. Jesus says Bo. I don't know. I guess he's into Bo. He's watching old fucking football commercials. Michael Jordan dice, Lily, ven pa acá pa ponerte en enema de... that's very descriptive. Do you need an enema? You know that? That's very... A cleansing enema?
No.
You sure? There you go. Mira, Jesus says that you need to have a pizza face to be considered acne, and you don't have that, mijita. Necesita un lechazo para contener el acne. Es verdad. A little lechazo in the face would do you fine. Really?
Yeah.
Did you know that if you stopped eating Kit Kats, you wouldn't get 4 pimples every time you get your period either?
I asked my doctor for...
Can you please go pick up the mail for today? It's very important.
What?
There's a package in there that's very important. Could you please go get it?
Is it a fucking bomb? Is it going to blow up before?
No, because I wouldn't ask you to go get it. Come mierda. It's important. Please, it's time sensitive. Really, you're going to make this stupid fucking... Esta cara de ñoña. Ay, por tu madre. Oye, mi gente, déjame hacerte una pregunta. Do you have any women in your life that are like this? Is this me? Am I the only fucking person that has to deal with this bullshit? Do you have a girlfriend, a wife, a daughter, a fucking niece? Una como pinga que tienes al lado, vecina, que no te para de joder. Una singona. Is this common? Porque, mira, la verdad que yo no sé. Porque la única mojona come mierda que yo tengo en mi vida, ¿ok? Y le digo come mierda de cariño porque, you know, she's not a stupid girl. Lo que es una come mierdona, like a child. I don't deal with this shit. The girls that I date that are her age... You know, have a pussy, you know? They don't fucking complain about anything. Coño, yo le meto la pinga en el culo y no se quejan. ¿Qué pinga se van a quejar? Porque, ay, they woke up a little sick. No joda, tú. ¿Tú sabes cuántos plan Bs? Yo tenía una jeva una vez que se metió por lo menos 7 plan Bs en 3 semanas. That shit can't be fucking, you know, code safe. Se lo metió de todas pingas esa tipa por poco bota el útero por el culo. She didn't fucking complain. What the fuck is this? It's the pussification. It's the pussification of the youth of today. And I wanted to talk about marijuana and be chill today. But instead I'm talking about why everybody around me that's under the age of 30 is a fucking pussy. ¿Qué repinga está pasando aquí, mi gente? Is this going on nationally or is it just in Miami? Que here we mimar los niños. Aquí los chavacos se quedan en la casa hasta los 37 años. Y después dicen, coño, mami, me voy a buscar una casa ahora. Ahora sí que me voy a mudar en un apartamento en Miami Lake. ¡Ni pinga! They call those guys Twixers, by the way. The ones that don't leave home until they're 34. And some of them stay there. I love the excuses. No, the best is the excuses. No. Once you pass a certain age, like 28, you know, and they're like, no. My parents live with me. No me diga, mijito. No me lo diga. Coño, qué rico. My parents live with me. Eso le dicen a la puta cuando la traen en la casa. Y la tiene que llevar. And you take her to your fucking bedroom, okay? To fuck you on your Power Ranger sheets, okay? When you're fucking 28 years old todavía haciéndote paja because you play Batman. No joda, viejo. That's how you know you don't live with that you live with your parents and your parents don't live with you. Si tú no te puedes sacar la pinga, echar un palo borracho en el living room sin alguien joderte o decirte nada. Si tú puedes vivir así, entonces tus viejos viven contigo. Pero si tú tienes que, you know, cover your pinga o lo que el culo, no puedes tirarte pedo donde saca el culo en la casa. No, mijito, tú vives con tus padres. Perdóname, olvídate de eso. Dime, guardito, a ver, take it easy, viejo. No, no, dime tú, viejo. Claro que dejaste take it easy, pero ¿qué voy a hacer? Yeah, venga, a ver, Marquito aquí Mendoza me dice, talk it up. Nino, send Pepe some more of that good stuff, bro. No, let's talk, yeah, vamos a cambiar el tema porque no voy a, you know, I don't want to pussify this fucking show anymore with this bullshit. So, she runs into your mom into the bathroom. André, no, eso, Andrea, eso es verdad. I can imagine that it's, you know, a little bit more awkward for the woman, if anything, you know. Porque la vieja, la jeva dice, ah, tus padres viven contigo, coño, qué bien. Ah, y los viejos están durmiendo porque son las 3 de la mañana, qué pinga. Pero después la jeva se va, tú sabes, to squeeze a lavarse el bollo antes que se singe, que te singue, o a refrescarse la papaya un poco antes que te la enseñe. And she goes to the bathroom and has to run into your mother as she's coming out. Después de que echó un tremendo mojón en el toilet ese, la vieja pinga esa, después de comerse un arroz con frijoles y un fucking, y un bistec a la lomilla, ok, con yuca y boniato y con cebolla y la peste, vaya, cebollín y mojón que hay en el baño, eso se lo tiene que tragar la pinga, la jeva esta. Repinga, ¿tú te imaginas la jeva esa lo que tiene que tragarse eso? You know what? That's the kind of smell que, vaya, she's gonna keep, you know, she goes into that bathroom and it smacks her in the fucking face once she fucking smells that shit. You know, she tastes that shit in the back of her fucking throat. Yeah. No, I'm talking about the awkward moment when your, you know, girl, like, fuck for the night, runs into your mom in the bathroom. Has that ever happened to you? Have you ever stayed over a boyfriend's house who told you that he lives, that his parents live with him? And you go take a shit, or you go to the bathroom to refrescarte la papaya, and you run into his mom coming out of the bathroom after she just squeezed out tremendo mojón de un caldo gallego que se comió en la carreta 3 horas antes. No, none of that ever happened to you? Never? You've never tasted a caldo gallego fart that belonged to somebody else, Lily? Lily, are you going to answer anything I ask you today with fucking a little bit of animation, or are you going to be a big pain in the ass for the rest of the day? Eddie, it happened to me on my 17th birthday. Yo, pinga. A ver, the last one is so true, Andrea. And your mom thinks that she will be your wife. No, 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 pinga. That's the worst. That's the worst. Ay, mira, este va a ser la novia tuya. No, mami, como que tú le vas a decir a la vieja. O a la abuela que se encuentra con la puta. Porque tú no puedes decir a la abuela tuya que le estás trayendo las putas hasta la casa. La abuela te caga patada por culo. You can't tell your abuela that. No, abuela, esto no es novia mía, esto es una amiguita mía. Porque después la abuela dice, ah, tú me estás trayendo puta a esta casa. ¿Tú crees que esto es una casa de gente decente, no un putero, mijito? You can't tell your abuela that. That's inappropriate. Te va a joder el palo, la mamadita. You can't do that shit. Pepe, where's Bachi Balls? Bachi Balls está en lo del viejo. Pero eso pasa, eso, por eso está el Airport Executive or Miami Princess. $60 for hours. No, Eduardo, ahí te la comiste. It's the truth. But the problem is that there's a lot of fucking cheap motherfuckers in this fucking city que no quieren, they don't want to spring for that shit, okay? And, you know, that's how you can tell a young man from a mature man. The guy that, you know, wants to fuck you in the car or take you back to his parents' house, sneak your ass in or something, you know, and fuck you in his twin size bed on his fucking Power Ranger sheets next to his Xbox controller. Es un copa pinga.
I agree.
Cualquier mojón. Coño, si tú tienes dos dedos de frente and you're 23 years old, I don't care if you think your dick is made out of fucking, you know, oak. You know, if you have some class, you take that girl to a fuck motel. I mean, and that says a lot because there's not a lot of class associated with a fuck motel. I mean, have you been to one of those, Lily?
No.
Good answer.
Damn, I lost my...
Gran chancletazo de te deja tu abuela. Absolutely. Living at home, they have money. No joda. Absolutely, coño. They live at home. They probably fucking drive. Están en FIU, okay? Tienen un pantancito ahí para pagar el celular y su come pinguería. El padre le paga el seguro del carro porque tú sabes que a los 20 años tú estás pagando por el culo por un Toyota Terceo y no puedes estar en eso en la educación. So, imagínate tú. Sí, el tipo, ¿qué pinga está haciendo? El tipo es un coma pinga. No, he doesn't save, para que tú veas cómo son los mojones. No. I'm gonna spend it on Malis and Barros, man. Pero cuando se liga una muñeca que le quiere mamar la pinga, she has to do it in the fucking passenger side seat of his fucking Honda Civic. at the fucking Lover's Lane on the airport. Is that still a thing, Lily? Do people still fuck on Lover's Lane?
I've never been to Lover's Lane.
Good answer.
I don't even know. How is that Lover's Lane going to the airport?
There's a strip of land that faces the airport around Perimeter Road that they've called, I don't know, they called the Lover's Lane back in my day. But that was where everybody went to go echar un palo and watch the plane. It's romantic, you know? You see the planes landing. It's
That's
nice.
That's romantic.
What do you mean it's not? Of course it's romantic.
No, it's not.
It's beautiful. It's dark. Yeah. You see planes.
Seeing planes come and go that you aren't on, like...
Yeah, but you see them landing, and
how
it's beautiful because there's
romantic?
Because there's lights,
being
and you have
plane?
Like nice, you have music on, like Coño Lily. You can't put your, you can't imagine
you know what's
that.
Romantic being on that plane on the way to Hawaii. That's romantic.
Yeah, well, you're asking for a lot for a 22-year-old in FIU studying liberal arts. I mean, I'm saying that if you're, you know, you can't. That's like, you know, that was the place
liberal
to go,
arts.
Or the other place you would go to was the, what was that other fucking place they would go to in the In Brickell, by La Playa Los Perros.
Uh-huh.
Oye, tú vas, not Brickell, Key Biscayne. If you go to Key Biscayne, you pass the Rickenbacker Causeway, the first parking lot that you run into on your right-hand side.
Yeah.
What the fuck was that?
That was my phone.
Oh. if the first parking lot you run into on the right, that's the fuck parking lot.
It is?
After 12 o'clock.
I mean,
yeah, that's where everybody
that's
goes to fuck.
The beach that my sister likes to go to.
La Playa Los Perros. Sí, coño, verdad. A ver, ¿quién me habla ahí? You're live on the air.
Hey, what's up, Jesús?
¿Qué vuelta, Jesucito? Dime que volá.
Oye, I said, I was just going to tell you about La Playa Los Perritos at Hobie Beach.
Ah, coño, bro, La Playa Los Perros. Eso es famoso, bro. Eso es famosísimo. ¿Tú has echado un palo ahí?
Claro, se llama La Playa de los Wubu.
Okay, that's where you do it doggy style. It wasn't because you could take your fucking dog there to go on the beach. Who the fuck does that? Nobody does that in Miami. Los cubanos no llevan a los esos cosas haitianos. Llevan los perros a la fucking playa. Y que pinga, quien quiera hacer eso, quien quiera bañar con un perro que se va a echar un mojón en el agua. Que pinga voy ahí yo. Eso le dicen la playa de los perros, porque ahí donde se singa doggy style. That's
the
true story. Y en el farito, okay, es donde tú vas a repartir pinga por todos lados. Porque el farito, you've been to el farito, ¿no?
No, claro, but there's a better spot. You got to go to Virginia Key Beach, porque por ahí, back in the day, when you had to go to Virginia Key Beach, eso era un caminadito por la oscuridad. Like you had to go deep in there to get to the beach.
Yeah, man,
that.
But you might get fucking robbed or killed, porque esa era la playa de los delincuentes.
Wow, used to be La Playa de los Negros back in the 60s. And shit.
Bueno, but that's the 60s. I'm talking like in the 90s. Eso era la playa. Bro, that's where I saw a hip-hop show there. It was called Beach Fest.
Yeah,
I saw. Yo vi a Biggie Small. Yo vi a Wu-Tang Clan. Vi a una. El Outcast. Vi todo eso. Yo fui porque yo no sabía ni pinga de eso. Yo era un. Imagínate, yo era marimbero. A mí lo que me gustaba era Hansel y Raúl y toda esa mierda. Ahí es donde metí yo en el hip hop duro. Porque me ligué tremenda negra tomándose un St. Ides to the face 64 ounce. Que dije, coño, qué negrona esta. Pero ahí lo que eso estaba lleno de delincuente y diente oro. No joda. De pinga.
No, claro, claro.
Eso ya no es así, ¿no?
Oye, pero either way, man, I love your show, bro. Keep it up, man.
Ah, coño, yo, ya me vas a colgar. Me cago en ti, viejo. Oye, te quiero y me quedo corto, Jesucito.
Dale, macho, que te ríes.
Dale, mi hermano. Oye, Jesucito me cortó la llamada con un cingado. No quería preguntar, no quería. He didn't want to answer my question of whether Virginia Key Beach is still a delincuente beach. Is that a delincuente beach?
I don't know. You're asking me, like, I'm this expert of all.
Chica, pero what the fuck do you do with your time? Just throw up and take pills? Is that what you do? Take antibiotics and
you know
get
what?
Sick?
Like, I'm trying to... I'm here. And you know how hard it is for me to be here? Because, like, I feel so bad. And, like, you're going to criticize me. Don't criticize me. I'm being fucking a trooper right now.
What? Great. Fantastic. I got to give you fucking... What? So I got to pay you for just sitting there and doing nothing? That's what you're doing? You're going to scratch your face with that microphone? Don't do that ever again. Because I'm going to catch you on fucking video. And I'm going to say, look at Lily. Look at Lily.
Look at Lily.
Look at Lily. A Freudian dick microphone black.
Freudian.
Dick microphone, because that looked like you were just rubbing una pinga on your face.
It feels good.
No, no, that's what she said. I'm sure they all feel good on the face. Oye, anyway, hablando de todo un poco, Virginia Key Beach, you've never been there, Lily?
I'm sure I've been there. I don't know that it's a delinquent beach.
I mean, it used to be the delinquente beach. That was
really?
The beach? Yeah, absolutely. That's where you were. That's where you would go if you were a Wilo or IMP. Or some of that bullshit, and you will go get into a gang fight in the Virginia Key Beach and then go to South Beach and hang out. Yeah, it was crazy. It was at Alabama. Holy shit, there's tons of Jesus here listening to Pepe, LOL. Yeah, hay muchos Jesuses aquí. Chiri Lili. Oye, Lili. But let me tell you, it's the truth. That's what Virginia Key Beach. Well, they still have Marley Fest there, I think.
What, Marley? Isn't that Marley Fest? Isn't that Bayfront Park?
No, Marley Fest was at Virginia Key Beach.
I thought it was at Bayfront or Bicentennial.
No. Well, I don't know about this year, but traditionally it was on Virginia Key Beach. And you would go there and you would smoke incredible. Didn't that shit just pass?
I don't know. I don't smoke. You're acting like I'm the...
Ay, chica, ¿pa qué pinga tú? Do me a favor, chica. ¿Por qué no te vas para el baño? Y te... Vaya, te ahogas en el toilet para la pinga o algo, chica. Why don't you go?
I tried to, but you told me to get on the
Anda,
mic.
Pinga. ¿Por qué no vas a echar una cagadita o algo? Haz algo, entretengue. Ve y métete el dedo en el culito o algo, chica. Mira a ver si haces algo. Textea a tu noviecito y dile how sick you feel or some shit. Go Snapchat pictures of your pussy. I don't know. Do something, mijita, because you're useless right now.
I'm sorry, Pepe. I'm trying to be
so. Mira what Dito aquí dice. Coño, Virginia Key Beach was cleaned up. IMPs, yo, back in the day. It's the truth. It's the truth. Ahí veía en todos los IMPs y los Wilos de Hialeah, porque Wilos era todos Hialeah people. En Kendall lo que había eran los IMPs y ¿cómo se llaman los tipos estos? Coño, que era este... Coño, el Syndicate y todos esos gangas era chamaco, las gangas de chamaco, eso que todos vendían perico por todos lados para los marimberos grandes de aquí. Coño, yo me acuerdo, ¿cómo me voy a acordar yo de eso? ¿Qué pinga? Ya eso no existe, aquí no hay ganguero. Now people, they don't do that. Now they're in tailor-made gangs and rap and fucking sing songs about why girlfriends, how they're, what was that fucking Drake song? Marvin's Room. And they sing songs about how Baby Judy, everyone...
You're all I ever need.
No, the other one. The one that goes, you were just practice. All those guys were just practice. They fuck. That's what guys do now. They don't join gangas and beat the shit out of each other like they used to back in the day when they were men and they didn't have to go to the hospital every time they blew a fart out the wrong hole. No. The pinga. Back then, they beat the shit out of each other with chains and baseball bats and fucking all that shit in clubs out and beat them fucking busted old e-bottles over their heads outside of Zippers or fucking Crackles or all of those fucking clubs.
What do you call it? The pussy?
Okay, and they had big fucking balls and were men. Ahora los hombres se pasan el día figuring out, vaya, a ver cómo voy a escribir un rap aquí about how I'm a tarru. Coño, ¿cómo soy tarru? A ver, all those men were just practice. Singa todo lo que te gusta, puta. Sigue singando, que cuando tú me llegues a mí, it's practice. Vas a saber singar. Una canción para las putas y los tarrus. That's what guys do now. And bleach their fucking hair, you know.
And their assholes?
Yes, and their assholes. And fucking wear skinny jeans and lose weight and look like bitches. That's what fucking young people do these days. Vaya, la jevas. There's, you know, it's funny. I look at CrossFit bitches today on the fucking Instagram.
Yeah.
Okay? That are like 22 and 23 year olds. And I look at males that are 22 and 23 years old. The fucking girls got more balls and more muscles and more fucking... son más machos que los pencos que estoy viendo yo en Instagram. Estos como pinga estos que se pasan el dedo con el dedo en el culo.
I think the girls are trying to make up for what the guys nowadays are lacking. Don't you think?
How so? By taking steroids and growing an enlarged pepa?
I mean,
is that in style now to have an enlarged pepa? Is that the thing? That's like the new, that's the new shit? You know what a pepa is?
No.
You don't know what a pepa is?
No.
Here, do me a favor. Look up, go on the internet. You're on the internet, right? Here, look this up.
I'm not on the internet, but.
Go on there. Okay, look this up. China doll enlarged.
Oh, I know what that is.
No, you don't even know what the fuck I'm talking about. I could be talking about a fucking doll from China. Come on, pinga, look. You don't know what the fuck I'm talking about.
You're saying enlarged head.
No, not enlarged head. That's not a... No. China doll enlarged. And then look at the first three pictures that come up on Google Images. And tell me which one you think I'm talking about. Go ahead. What do you think? What is it? Which one? What?
It's a large clitoris.
Or a small penis.
Or a large clitoris.
Yeah, there you go. That's real shit.
No, that's not real.
What do you mean that's not real?
Is
of course
that China, like WWF China?
That's the WWF of China, yeah. That's China's clitoris, her pepa. They call that a pepa in Cuban.
How did they, I mean, is that like a
name? It's also a name that you can call your abuela. Abuela Pepa.
Is that
Isn't that funny? That's probably how she got her name. She probably has a big fucking clit. Or era tremenda puta cuando joven. That's how she got her name. Abuela Pepa. ¿Por qué te dicen Pepa? Porque tengo el bollo en candela, mijita.
Ew.
You know?
sucio.
Do you never think about these things?
Of course not.
Se ve que tú eres una cobarde. Chica, you don't think your abuelos ever fucked? Let me tell you something. Your abuelos were probably freaks.
Well, I know one of them was. One was a big whore in Cuba.
Yeah, no. I mean, with your fucking abuela, you know what I'm saying? Like, they together were freaky.
Ew, no, they weren't.
All the things that you think that you see and whatever, they were doing that shit together. Aww. And made your parents. And then your parents did it and made you.
Ew, don't even say that.
And now here you are, like a coma pinga, throwing up when you take fucking antibiotics like a pussy. You think your parents had hot anal and vaginal fucking fuckathons listening to, you know, 80s cokehead music in fuck motels on Okeechobee to raise a little pussy girl?
I mean, I don't think I'm a pussy, but
you're a little bit of a pussy girl.
Why? Because I'm fucking sick? Like, what the fuck? I followed the doctor's directions. I took them with food. Oh, yeah. Like,
okay, Lily, whatever. Well, so what are your, you know, that's what girls look like now today.
What?
That take the juice.
They have big clits.
They have giant clits. I don't have a problem with that, by the way. Let me tell you.
You don't know? You like that?
I mean, I don't have a problem with it if a girl has a big clit. Do you know why?
Why?
Because that means it's easier for her to bust her, you know, get or have
so
a cum.
Do you suck it?
I mean, I do a lot of things. Like I sing it songs. Out. I fucking hum at it. I motorboat it. I play chess with it if I can. I do all kinds of things with that. You got to get creative. What the fuck? What do you do with your clitoris?
Why do you always like got to bring? I'm not going to talk about
Well, you asked me. I'm just asking, retorting. You said, what do you do with the clitoris? I described
it. No, I didn't say what you do with the clitoris. I said, what do you think,
chica? Like, that's
what do you
just
do with
there.
That
what do you
clitoris?
Think that's just there for fun?
No,
you think that,
bro,
that,
you don't need to teach
you think,
me
I mean,
how
it
to
is there for fun, but
no.
You think that's just there, extra parts?
No, I'm asking. I'm not talking about clitorises in general. I'm talking about an enlarged clitoris.
Look, you know what's in style? Bedazzling it.
Oh, I've heard of that.
Yeah, you can bedazzle your
vajazzle.
Clitoris.
It's called vajazzle.
No, it's called clidazzle. Because you do it on your clit.
You don't fucking bejazzle.
Yeah, you put a little diamond like stud on it.
It could get stuck.
Yeah, it's okay if it gets stuck. You know, it gives you no reason to fucking go in there and, you know,
get
it
out. Have it fucking removed from your urethra. That's fun.
Your urethra? Like, really? Of all fucking, what, really? You think a fucking, is your urethra so large that it's going to fit a fucking faux diamond little sticky?
You ever seen how little those things
you have,
can
what
get?
Do you got, a fucking Venus flytrap pussy?
You haven't seen how little those get? The little stones?
No, fantastic. Yes, absolutely, Lily. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Fucking glitter in your urethra hole.
Glitter clit.
Whatever, bro.
Glitter clit.
Yeah, chica. No me joda. Bueno, anyway, look, I want to talk about marijuana, and all I've talked about here is about you being a pussy, and la playa de los delincuentes. Thank you very much, Lily. So let's talk about marijuana, because today's 420, mijita.
Hey,
and speaking of 420, oye, happy 420 to all my marijuaneros out there. Pinga! Anda!
Sit this one out.
Oye, para que lo sepan, and you know, today being 420, if you're staying out in the Pembroke Pines, and you need to get any the smoke, you want to go get a bong or a pipe, today is like the Black Friday for marijuaneros. Go see Nino at Holy Smokes in Pembroke Pines and say Pepe Billete, and he'll give you 20% off. That's 20,
nice.
Yeah, that's 1/5 off of anything you buy over there that's marijuanero, just for saying my name, para que tú veas. Que esas cosas son aquí de la... My friend rubs his girl's pussy with Vicks before they fuck. That probably works very well, I would imagine. Yes, that would work. You know what? That's a fucking secret right there. Because it's like aloe mint.
Yeah.
And it makes the pussy a little bit more like sensitive to like... So you go like that, so you feel it. And yeah, I could totally see that. You know what else would work for that? You know that dentine, the Listerine little bottle that you do, bottle freshener for your mouth, or Benaca, a little Benaca spray. Tú le metes tres o cuatro Benaca spray. Ahí en el bollín. Benaca en el bollín. Olvídate. Que ahí lo que terminaste es con tremendo sensory pussy. Anthony says that he swears by it. No, yo me imagino que that shit works great. The problem with that is that there's not a lot of viscosity, so I can't imagine that it's very pleasing if you fucking, porque, you know, that shit, you need some fucking, like, you need some lubricant with viscosity in there, you know?
Yeah, you need something to get the juices flowing.
Yeah, like, you can't use Vaseline. Vaseline don't work on the pussy.
No?
No, it works good on an asshole, but you need, like, KY jelly, Astroglide, some shit like that for a pussy.
Astroglide? That's what it's called?
Astroglide, yeah.
It sounds like something like you like seal like something in your car with.
Yeah, like exactly. Astroglide. Well, you're definitely sealing an exit, an exhaust. That's for fucking sure. La pomada china, coño, that's fucking, yeah, and I think it would burn your dick, the head of your dick at least, Eddie. But if you're wearing a condom, I guess not. Pero la pomada china, tiger bomb pussy, coño, tiger bomb pussy, that would be amazing. How would Raid work? I think Raid would be appropriate if you met her at Le Boulevard, you know, if you met her like at the Bully or, you know, an Alapana or some shit. Un poco de mojo.
Your favorite.
Mojo en el mojo tetas.
La lechonería.
Oye, let me tell you something. Not for nothing, but mojo. Like, if you're into some freaky shit, next time you want to get into some freaky shit, mi gente, or if you're a girl and you want to really fucking feel some shit, you buy a bottle, a gallon of, like, some lechonera fucking mojo. You shake that shit up, okay? Warm it a little bit if you want to, okay? Put it back in the container, and you pour that shit all over your girl, which you get freaky like that, you know? Maybe do it maybe that day you buy like a kiddie pool or something so you don't make a mess out of your house. You put some candles around the kiddie pool, you know? And you make it look like it's a satanic ritual, but it's not. It's a ritual of love. And you pour all this mojo on her like she's like a noche buena. Noche buena fucking lechón que te vas a jamar y le comes el bollo por lo menos por 16 horas garantizado porque qué rico vas a ver eso. Yeah, Andrea definitely did a fucking video and it was inspired by the exact same story that I just told you. That's where the line mojo tetas, I got mojo tetas comes from.
And
me pouring mojo on tetas and enjoying it very, very much.
Yeah.
Oye, aquí la cosa está de pinga, coño, tú no, imagínate tú. Pero Lili, como te estaba diciendo, mira Jesús, aquí se está riendo. Oye, you did a music video, pues. Vaya, aquí la gente está a todo full. Lili, ¿qué pinga tú estás haciendo con la puerta, mijita? Que estás haciendo un noise aquí del coño su madre.
What? I had to open the door.
Anya, pinga, niña, pero you're just in the way about everything. So hablando de la marihuana, chica, let me ask you something. What do you think about this legislation in la marihuana in Florida in particular?
I'm unfamiliar with, can you refresh?
Oh, great. More useless fucking bullshit from Lili. Bueno, mijita, you know that in November they're going to vote once again on whether or not that legislature. Oye, yes, Lily, what's up with the fucking noise? What are you doing?
Really? What?
¿Qué es eso, Lily?
Oh, thank you.
Anyway, la marijuana legislation that they're going to pass.
You tell me, what is it? I don't know.
La verdad, que ¿por qué no te fuiste para la casa, mijita? Why didn't you go to your house?
I tried, but you told me to
porque
come.
¿Qué pinga tú pintas aquí hoy, mijita?
You told me to come.
No, I did not. You, somebody else. You just misheard. I was on the phone with Argentina in the middle of a Skype session between
disgusting.
Me and her.
So inappropriate.
I know, Andrea. Que No, what do you think about that, Lily?
Chimichurri? Oh, that sounds horrible right now.
Yeah, chimichurri boyo.
Chimichurri boyo.
Chimichurri pussy. Boyo. That would be something that you would do to like a girl that's from like, that's Nicaraguan.
What about a chimichanga pussy?
That's a Mexican girl. And that's what you do with, a girl that works like a Roberto's Taco Chop or some shit like that.
A what?
Roberto's Taco Chop.
Roberto's Taco Shop?
Yeah. You pick up the waitress from Roberto's Taco Shop like that. You tell her, oye, mama, los tacos estaban bien rico aquí, pero si quieres probar el chimichurri más rico de Miami, te invito.
Okay, Carlos and Anthony, I sent out the shirts. I got to check to see what the issue was because I sent out all...
Wasn't there an issue with some shirts that were returned to the post office and...
Yeah, they were marked undeliverable.
Yeah, and then some fucking sapingo kept them.
Yeah,
because they say Pepe Billete, you know, on them.
They said boy on them.
No, I know, come mierda, but the fucking postage says it was from me. Yeah, I know so there was an issue with that, but...
That's what I...
Well, whatever. Anyway, so marijuana legislation passing in Miami and becoming, or in Florida, and becoming, you know, it passed. Medical marijuana passed, or didn't pass, excuse me. It reached, what was it, 58% last time they voted on it?
How much do they need?
60.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that's why it's up.
Why isn't it 50? I thought 50.
No, you need like a super majority.
a super majority. So a majority doesn't
60%
count.
Of the
so
vote.
Majority doesn't count. Like now it's a super majority.
Yeah, what do you want me to tell you? Hey, que dijo Michael aquí? Un poco de mayo ketchup. No. Mayo ketchup. That's what happens when you fuck her on her period and come inside of her, Papa. That's what you make. You don't put that on there. You make that with her. That's when you fuck her with Red Wings and you blow a load in her. It's a cream pie, strawberry cream pie.
Boston cream pie.
No, strawberry.
Yeah, Boston.
No, why in Boston? What the fuck that's is in Boston? What's red about Boston?
That's the name of the fucking donut. Boston cream pie.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
A cream pie, Boston cream pie is cream colored.
It's cream with fucking
jelly. Yeah, a strawberry
with jelly,
jelly
bro.
Donut is fucking...
It's strawberry.
¿Qué pinga tú sabes de eso, mijita? You don't know what that
¿Qué
is.
Tú sabes de
Who, how many people have ever cream pie in your pussy when you were on your period? How many? Tell me five. Name me five guys that have done that to you.
None, bro. What the fuck?
Okay, so what the fuck do you know about anything? ¿Qué tú sabes de amor si nunca le has dado un beso a un caballo, vieja? Dale pa' la pinga. Coño, no joda, tú. How about the new $20 bill? What about the new $20 bill?
Oh, yeah, remember how I was telling you that they were originally going to change the dollar bill with Alexander Hamilton, but due to the...
Wait. Could you repeat what you just said? Because that made no sense.
Okay, they wanted
to... No, repeat what you just said.
They wanted to switch the $10 bill out to replace it with a woman.
Right, they wanted
to
change.
As you know,
Alexander Hamilton. Can I fucking clarify what you said?
Can I finish my fucking thought?
They wanted to replace Alexander Hamilton with Sacagawea.
I didn't hear that, but they wanted to replace him. But due to, you know, like that Broadway musical Hamilton, that's really big and like really big. They decided to withdraw that decision and they're going to replace the Andrew Jackson $20 bill with Harriet Tubman.
So the 20 is going to change now?
Yeah, to Harriet Tubman.
Andrew Jackson.
Yeah, we can get rid of him. It's fine.
I mean.
Yeah.
I mean,
fuck him.
Hamilton is the most gangster of all of the founding fathers.
The founding, yeah.
Why were you going to correct me on?
I was going to say, I think you're going to say the most gangster person on a bill. I was going to be like, no, it's Lincoln. But then you said founding fathers. And I'm
no,
like,
Lincoln wasn't a gangster. Hamilton was a fucking
Lincoln
gangster.
Lincoln is the biggest gangster.
Hamilton fucking died in a shootout against another guy, like shooting it like in a duel, like tremendo ganguero.
Yeah, they were just shitty men with just good ideas.
I mean, you know, okay. You know? That's more than it can say that I can say for anybody you've ever dated in your life. I mean, there have just been shitty guys with shitty ideas.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you've been a shitty girl with shitty take on yo. So this is what the new 20 is going to look like?
Yeah, look, Jackson was an Indian killer. Fuck him.
Rebinga, but what picture of Harriet Tubman are they going to use?
The only picture that they fucking used for Harriet Tubman ever.
I mean, there's like 17
pictures.
The one
of her like this.
The one where she has like a...
A little bonnet. It looks like
a black bonnet. Yeah. Yeah. That one they're going to use. I mean, that's a different picture.
Yeah. Sorry, Frank. I don't have my big girl pants on today. I don't feel good.
That's interesting that they would put her on the 20.
Why not? I mean, why is that? Why?
Well, because she was going to be on the 10 before. Now she's going to be on
the
20.
Well, they didn't.
I mean, why not put her on the fucking 50?
Who's on the 50?
Ulysses S. Grant.
That's true.
Right? It's Grant. No?
Yeah.
Grant's on the 50? Or I don't know why I'm thinking about Taft. It might be
I think
Taft.
It is. No, it's not Taft. I think it's Ulysses.
Or you know who else they could replace? I mean, they could replace the 5. I mean, Lincoln has a penny already.
So?
George Washington already has a fucking quarter.
And the dollar bill.
And the dollar bill.
Yeah, I mean, then for that.
Ben Franklin has the 100. He's going to be. You can't change. Because you're going to. If you change the 100, you can't change the 100 because then you have to fucking. Then the song, It's All About the Benjamins, Baby, makes no sense. And you can't do that. You can't just make a song make no sense, no frame of reference. In 20 years, people are going to listen to classic hip hop and go, what the fuck was that all about?
I mean, I think they kind of do that now when they hear like MySpace references and
no,
stuff.
No, nobody talks about fucking MySpace. But I mean, you know, it's what I'm making is a very clear point because if they won't change the 10 anymore because of a fucking play with a Puerto Rican guy, give me a fucking break. You don't think that they fucking not change the 100 because Puffy and Biggie did a hit song in the 90s?
I don't think that.
Get the fuck out of here. Pepe on our money. Yeah, Pepe Billete on our money.
Who do you think should
be
on, what woman in history do you think should be on the...
What Edie Chacon.
That she has no...
Edie Chacon should be on the Jackson founded the Democrat Party, so fuck him. Yeah, Jackson founded the Democrat Party, so fuck him. I agree.
What woman would you...
Because the Democratic Party was the fucking party of racists and fucking pieces of shit before 1960. Did you know that?
Yes.
The Republicans are free. The ones who freed the slaves. The Republicans were the ones that fucking did everything that has been meaningful and fucking amazing in this country up until the mid part of the 20th century. Did you know that? That's Republicans did that shit. You know, Lincoln freed the fucking slaves.
No shit. You're
Lincoln. And you know what Lincoln was? A Republican.
Republican.
That's right.
That's why he's the shit.
Yeah.
Not, he's not
you
the
better
shit.
Believe it.
Are you Mexican now?
You better fuck. No, I'm not. Why would you say I'm Mexican?
You're doing a Mexican accent.
¿Qué pinga Mexican accent, Lily? What's a Mexican accent sound?
Adele, wey.
Did I just say anything remotely close to that?
Yeah.
No.
That's why I said you sound like a Mexican.
No.
We're Mexican. Remember, we're all Mexican. La, 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 la.
Qué manera de comer pinga la tuya. Pepe needs to be on the 20. Grant is on the fucking, on the 50. Pancake one. No, I think Edie Chacon should be on the, like,
why? She's
on the
not
two.
Even American.
You know what? Maybe they should have given the $2 bill to, you know, not change any of our money and put this woman on the $2 bill.
Do we even produce $2 bills?
Of course
bills?
We produce $2 bills. Yeah. I mean, they're, you know.
They're not, are they in circulation? No, right?
Yes.
I mean, I know. I mean, that's
what do you think?
Right.
That you are you one of those comapingas that finds a $2 bill and keeps it in their wallet for the next 50 years? No, go to the bank and ask for your paycheck in $2 bills. You'll get it.
Yeah, you have to go to the bank to get it. You don't. They don't use it as like you can't go to a. You go to like a clothing store and you won't. They won't give you $2 bills as change.
They will if they have
they
one
carry,
in the register.
I mean, but they don't. Do they? I know if they have one in the register. But
yeah,
it's
exactly.
Not,
but they're used. I don't know for fucking what. I don't know why they're produced, but they are. You can get your whole check in $2 bills in a bank. You never done that shit?
No.
I've gone to the bank
have
and taken
it. Have you done it in quarters?
No. I've gone to the bank and taken out $5,000 in $2 bills to go to the strip club, though. Because it makes you different and unique.
What coin is Kennedy on?
The half dollar.
Why is he on the half dollar? Why isn't he should be on a better... On a better coin.
I mean, he's the youngest president to be on any fucking, to be memorialized on any fucking, on any money. That's an incredible honor.
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you know that that half dollars used to be made out of real silver?
I mean,
no.
Weren't pennies made out of copper? And
I think they still are made out
no,
of copper.
No, they're not made out of copper. You know, it costs more to make a penny than it actually, like a penny.
They are made of copper.
No, they're not.
Oh my God. Really? You're going to go through this right now? You're going
to. I saw it. There's a whole group of people that are trying to save the penny.
Mijita, look at what a penny does, how it oxidizes. Of course it's made out of copper.
It's not made out of copper.
You know what's made out? What do you think? Copper is a precious stone?
No, but
crackheads steal them in Wynwood or used to all the time. Yeah, look. Some pennies are 97% zinc compositions and others are 95% copper composition. With the exception of...
What year were those fucking copper pennies produced?
1992 and on. In 1982, they were using zinc. Comapinga.
They use zinc? They don't
Now they use copper-plated zinc.
Exactly. They're just not fucking copper pennies. There's a whole group of people that are trying to save the penny because they say that the penny is like a pointless. We spend, I don't know how many bills. I think it's like over a billion.
Well, let me tell you something. If you lick a penny and then lick an asshole, it tastes a lot alike. So there you go.
That's so gross.
No, it's not.
Like a new penny or an old penny?
Like any penny. Do you take a penny? You want to lick a penny real quick and taste what my asshole feels like? You could taste a penny and it'll remind you of what a culeco tastes like. You know, it also tastes like that when you put your fucking tongue on a square battery. It's the same feeling.
I've done that.
Licking an asshole, licking a penny, and putting your tongue on a square battery. All are equal experiences.
What do you think the relationship, why is that?
What is the relationship?
Like, if you lick a penny.
I think it's a mystery of the fucking universe. Oh. Like, you know, I don't know.
Like where we come from?
Who cares what the relationship is? That's a fucking, like a wonder of the world that your asshole tastes like a penny and like a battery.
Do all assholes taste like that?
I haven't been through all assholes in my life, Lily, but I would imagine that, yeah, most of them do.
Like most of them do?
Yeah, it's like a chocolate starfish. Do you ever have a chocolate starfish?
No.
You like chocolate, right?
Yeah, but not starfish.
Why do you sound... You know that you are this bullshit that you're putting... Your posture and your voice right now on the radio...
What?
Sounds horrible. Can you give the phone number, please?
305-853-8080.
One more time.
305-853-8080.
One more time.
305-853-8080.
Thank you. You could clean a penny with ketchup. Makes it look brand new. Yeah, that's the citric acid in the tomatoes. You can also put a steak in a fucking pitcher of Coca-Cola, and it'll be gone in 24 hours.
Have you ever put Mentos in a
El beso negro! en pingaísimo. I love that. Coño, the real ghostwriter. Eso me lo dio. Me lo dio buenísimo. ¿Qué pinga es eso?
I don't know. That's not me. That's you.
What the fuck is that?
That's not me. That's your fucking computer.
It's not over here.
Oh.
¿Qué pinga estaba ringing like that, Lily? That was your
phone. That
fucking...
wasn't my phone. I'm looking at my phone.
Yo estoy fumando marihuana y tú estás comiendo, pinga.
Bro, I'm not. I'm trying to get through the show.
Bueno, anyways, what I was saying about the legislation, they're thinking that it might pass here in Florida.
I think it should pass.
This time around. I mean, whether you think it should or not, the possibility is what's important. Why do you think it should pass, by the way?
Because I think people should, you know, participate in whatever recreational fucking things that they want.
So you think that flaca should be legal too?
I don't think synthetic drugs, no. No synthetic drugs. No. Natural occurring.
So then any marijuana that's not grown from the ground, so wax and creepy and hydro and all that shit shouldn't be, because that's synthetically made.
I think hallucinogens, yeah, because hallucinogens.
Oh, you're okay with hallucinogens?
They expand your mind and like take.
Oh, they expand your mind. Oh, no, tell.
Consciousness.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Do tell.
Yeah.
Do you know that you take LSD 7 times, you're legally insane?
That's not true.
Yes, it is.
I've taken LSD.
What the fuck does that have to do with the way that you with legal shit? Mira, let's ask the chat room. I bet anybody in here,
an
abogado?
That's an urban legend that you hear like in fucking like in Miami Lakes about like, yo, if you take acid, bro, like they can what's that one that they can do, a spinal tap, that they could fucking pull your fluid from your spine?
Well, I mean, that is true.
Hey, bro, but that's bullshit. I take an acid.
Why is that bullshit? So what? You've taken acid. What the fuck
I'm
does
fine.
That have anything to do
I'm fine.
With
I'm not crazy.
How you can measure for it or whether
but
you
I've
legally
been,
you can
I've,
declare
I've,
insanity?
I've,
how does those things have anything?
I'm not declared.
Do you know that there's a guy named Ben Folds who used to be in a band called Ben Folds Fights who wrote a song about his friend who took acid one night, went up into a tree because he thought he saw Jesus, went crazy, and has been locked up in an insane asylum since 1991?
Bro, but that's anything. There's
from people, one hit of acid?
That's everybody has different reactions. There's people that have crazy fucking paranoia due to like smoking marijuana one time. Like, shit happens, bro.
Damn, that means I'm fucked. Well, no, I mean, it doesn't mean you're fucked. It means that legally in the court of law, I think you can declare insanity. Pink Floyd singer never came back from the LSD trip. That's right. His name was Sid something, if I'm not mistaken, right? What was that guy's name in the Pink Floyd?
But I think hallucinogens should be legalized. Marijuana, too.
How do you believe the hallucinogens that
because
could cause
I've done them,
insanity?
So
they could make you, put you in a paranoid schizophrenic state. They could cause delusion on one hit. How do you feel that should be legal?
I don't think that everybody should just, okay, I don't think everybody should partake in them. I think that you should.
Sid Barrett. There you go, Anthony.
You shouldn't
That's
take
right.
them to get fucked up. Like, you should take them because like you want to expand your mind and your fucking
who the
thinking.
Fuck wants to be on a trip for 12 fucking hours?
I mean, I think if you're like that person that wants to get fucked up.
You know, peyote's nice.
Yeah, that's a hallucinogen. That's natural. It's a cactus that grows.
It's a fungus, but.
It's a cactus that you dry out.
No,
man. And
no. Clearly,
yes,
you did not.
Binga.
Clearly, in
peyote.
Miami. Clearly, in Miami Lakes, you didn't live long enough to fucking know that you can go to the Miami Lakes cows right next to Boca de Pepo.
Those are called mushrooms.
And when they take a shit. Mijita, what do you think peyote is?
Peyote is a cactus that grows in the desert.
It's a mushroom.
That you dry out and you put it into a tea and you drink that. Peyote's, they're called buttons.
They're the caps from the mushrooms.
No,
Mijita.
Bro.
And they grow
can somebody,
in cow
Henry,
shit.
Henry, help me out.
And they
Henry,
grow in cow shit.
What
Lily.
Is peyote? Is peyote shrooms or is peyote a cactus? Henry, come on.
They grow in these mushrooms, these hallucinogenic mushrooms grow in different parts of, in different fucking, in different things, Lily. They're
yeah.
It's fungus. It grows in a lot
That's
of
not
shit.
Peyote.
Literally.
Look
and
it up.
fungus, okay? Has a little fucking chemical in it, all right? I don't know what the fuck it is. I was going to say wormwood, but I'd be talking shit. That creates this effect of hallucinogenic for you, okay?
Isn't that what's in, like, absinthe?
The wormwood is what's in absinthe and what was in some other shit for a while, too. I think that shit was in it's in a cactus? Really, Brian? This shit grows in a fucking cactus? What? No,
I love how you need other people to reassure.
So what the fuck is cow shit mushroom?
Those are mushrooms.
How do cow shit mushrooms
Those
get you high?
Fungus. I don't know what fucking what's in the mushrooms that gets you high. I just know that peyote is a
So peyote is not a mushroom?
No. And it's the religion of the Native Americans. Well, some Native Americans.
Oh, peyote is the religion.
Peyote
that's the most racist, inaccurate statement
me.
You've ever made
peyote
in your life.
Peyote
is a ceremonial in some Native, is ceremonially used in some Native American cultures in a shamanistic fucking religious
experience. True, and they're
thing.
The only people.
Not, it's what the Native Americans believe in. Like,
religion,
si fueran todo craquero o algo, cojones.
Their religion's called peyotism, and they're the only people that are legally allowed to take peyote.
Okay, está bien, mijita. Esos son cuatro comapinga de gringo San Francisco que fueron al City Hall y dijeron, oye, yo quiero coger nota, let's create a religion, and they named it after that shit.
Oye, tune in, and drop out. No?
You dropped out of school. That's why you.
I didn't
that's,
drop
that's
out
That's the
of
problem.
School.
Is that what it is, no?
No, that's
That's why you're
theory,
fucking.
Bro.
Is that why you're acting like such a fucking ditz today?
How am I acting like a ditz? I'm giving you knowledge. I'm giving you a quote from a very famous person that studied the use and effects of LSD.
Ay, mija, por favor, mira. You can get high on fucking anything. Did you know that you can get high licking an asshole for enough time?
Did you know you can get high on if you shit and piss in a bottle and you put a balloon on it and you leave it in the sun for 3 days and you inhale the gas?
Yeah, it's called methane. You could do the same. You can accomplish the same fucking thing by buying a bottle of methane in a fucking Home Depot and just huffing methane.
I didn't know that.
You don't have to smell shit and piss like a fucking peasant. Okay? Like a fucking peasant. That's some bullshit.
What's the thing that people do with the air conditioning machines?
Freon.
No,
yeah.
they that black cable.
Yeah, Freon. I don't. That's nobody. I don't know. Is that a thing?
You don't know anybody that's done
Who
that?
The fuck huffs Freon?
I
nobody does that. That's some craquero shit, man.
I agree. Yeah, and I'm into the shit that yeah. Albert Hoffman is the guy that he synthesized LSD.
Well. I don't know about LSD so much. I don't think LSD is a very... I think if you can take a drug that can make you go crazy, I don't think it's very
but
safe.
But you could get psychosis.
I don't think a synthetic drug that can possibly make you... You're not going to go crazy taking, you know, mushrooms. But if you can go... Like, there are many reported cases of people fucking losing their mind and going into delirium from taking synthetic LSD. So fuck that shit. But I do think that ecstasy should be legal. MDMA.
Why? That makes people fucking... They fucking die. People die from taking LSD.
No, they...
Yes,
LSD?
They do.
LSD?
I mean, from ecstasy.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
LSD, they don't die from taking LSD.
No, not LSD.
They
you're
die
right.
from
ecstasy.
Not... I mean, they don't die from taking ecstasy. They die from not... For being un comapinga, not hydrating all night, jumping up and down, their rate, temperature goes up, and they usually... And they don't just die. That just doesn't happen. Well, that's a mentira. Because I've taken fucking triple-stacked Mitsubishis that were dirty as fuck because those were the best ones back in the fucking late 90s, okay? That means that they were laced with all kinds of great shit, okay? Triple-stacked Mitsubishis or triple-stacked Crowns that were fucking delicious to the face 8 at a time, and I'm still here.
See, I don't see the point in ecstasy. Like,
what
I don't
do you mean?
Feel like, I don't know. I've
because
never,
it makes you feel euphoric.
I've never done it.
Mira, I think amphetamines and perico should be fucking legal.
Well, the thing is, like,
because they make you productive.
Lily should have done her
maximum
show.
Impact can fuck your brain. I don't know what maximum impact is. Whipped cream, yeah, those are whippets.
I don't know.
They die from the dirty shit. Lily should have done the show on this topic and not the bloody pussy. Yeah, there you go, Lily. You should have talked about hallucinogens the day that you had.
I mean, you know, I
a fucking
I know
MMA
a lot
fighter here,
it.
Not talk about, you know, shitting on people's chests.
I know a lot about this because of, like, because, you know, the music of, like, the 60s and, like, you know, like, the counter.
Oh, because, you
but,
know.
You know what, bro?
Because you used to. Because you're so psychedelic and you listen to
I like that.
Jefferson. That's the fucking worst music ever.
What, psychedelic rock?
Psychedelic
Why?
Rock is garbage. That's shit.
Bro.
That is absolute shit. You know, the best rock and roll came out of the 70s.
Okay, but that's...
The 50s rock and roll, pinga, because that's like that fucking, that bubblegum bullshit. I mean, unless you were fucking, you know.
Well, like late 60s. I mean, you have all these great, you have like Joplin.
Early 60s, whatever. You know, that's when the Beatles started to come into their shit.
The Beatles, bro.
Late 60s. What's good in the late 60s?
The Beatles, the Beach Boys.
I mean, aside from the Beatles, the Beach Boys weren't a rock and roll group. That's not rock and roll.
Who's not?
Les Zeppelin, Rolling Stone.
Beach Boys
that's
are,
rock and roll. Beach Boys aren't rock and roll. Not really. That's not rock. That's like surfer rock. Not even. Like Dale. What is it? Dick Dale is surfer rock. Beach Boys are more like a doo-wop band than anything else. They're pop. They're pop music.
Well, I think Pet Sounds is a little bit more like...
That's not rock and roll, Lily.
It sounds like rock and roll to
Lily,
me.
Lily, that's what rock and
it's
roll sounds...
It's not Zeppelin.
That's what rock and roll sounds like. La verdad que tú nunca has singado.
Oye, Pinga, can
singado.
I say something? It's not Zeppelin or like Pink Floyd.
By a fucking lot.
But it's rock and roll.
Pink Floyd is progressive.
What do you mean? Little Richard is rock and roll.
Yeah, exactly. And that's closer. That's
Johnny
way
Cash is
closer.
Rock and roll.
That is way closer to Led Zeppelin. Okay? Little Richard And Johnny, what is it? Johnny, what was the name of the guy
Johnny
that married
Cash?
This guy? No, Johnny Lee,
Jerry Lee Lewis.
Jerry Lee Lewis. And even Johnny fucking Cash are much closer to Led Zeppelin than fucking the Beach Boys are.
I think the Beach Boys are rock, they're early rock.
What? Like, name me a song.
Fucking.
I'm not taking away from the Beach Boys. I think they're fucking great. I love Brian. What's his? I think he's great, but he's not
Brian
a rocker.
Wilson.
They're not Brian Wilson. That's not rock and roll. Mira, you want to hear some good shit? Mira, listen, this is rock and roll. Yeah. This is, you know, rock and roll makes you want to snort cocaine and
that's
fuck bleach blonde bitches. No, man.
What do you mean?
Anything in the 70s makes you want to snort cocaine.
Well, look at the sub.
Shut up and listen to rock and roll, baby. Yeah. Like that. Ha. Wow. These guys dress like bitches, but god dang it if they didn't make some good fucking rock and roll.
But look at early rock and roll. Like, that wasn't what they were talking
good
about.
Shit.
Like,
look, okay. Shut up. Listen. Listen what this song's about. Listen. I love this song. Nice. Saturday night, I like to fuck my girl, and right now I got a big something. I'm always working, slaving every day. Try to get the pussy, but same old, same old. I need a chance just to get away. If you can hear me and say, this is what I say. Don't need nothing but a boyo. How can I resist? That's good fucking rock and roll right there. That's good shit.
I mean, there's an evolution to it.
Yeah, man. But that's that's in the fucking 80s.
Shit changes,
the
though.
Shit in the 70s was even more. Mira, somebody says that Johnny Cash is country. No, Johnny Cash is not
Johnny
country
Cash
music. Johnny Cash is not country music. Johnny Cash is rockabilly rock and roll.
Yeah.
You know, it sounds like where the
I hear the train a coming.
Yeah, where everything.
He's so rock and roll.
That's rock and Billy. Yeah, that's rock
he
and
shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. How can
I shot a man in Reno just to watch. I mean, you know, but then again,
right.
Country music is a very broad term.
Country
music is very broad. That can mean everything from fucking. You know, ¿cómo se llama? I'm so lonely, I could die. ¿Cómo se llama este tipo? Coño. Hank Williams, which is like, you know. You know, really fucking like
country
back there.
Western.
No, mijita, no. Country Western is like little cowboy. No, that
you're
what the
singing,
fuck am
you're
I singing?
Singing? Beach Boys.
I'm thinking about
Surfer
the song
girl.
That was in the Three
Surfer
Amigos.
Girl.
Whatever. Anyway, so fucking country Western. Country music is a very broad term, like rock music is. Country music can mean everything that's. Taylor Swift all the way to fucking El Comapinga.
Yeah, like
Hank
Shelton,
Williams.
Shake, what's his name though?
But rockabilly falls into that because rockabilly is a mixture of country and rock and roll.
Yeah.
You know? So it's that mixture where Johnny Cash was really one of the best that did that shit.
I agree.
Yeah, man. I like Johnny Cash.
Me too.
I like that.
He always wore black. That's
un tipo
like
pingú.
Swag.
Es un tipo pingú, así. Un gringo pingú. Pero ¿sabes por qué a mí me gustaba Johnny Cash? Porque era un gringo que se metía tremendos trastazos vaya to the face. That guy would take eight balls to the face and then go sing songs about shit.
He would take a lot of pills.
He would take all kinds of fucking amazing
things. A
lot
things. Of pills.
Cash is great. You know what's a great Cash song? When he got older, he did a cover of a Nine Inch Nails song called Hurt. And he did it, and it's fucking probably one of the best.
It's very haunting.
Yes. Well, it means a lot when it comes from a fucking 90-year-old man that, you know, is looking back on his life. That shit is amazing.
And the video, too, it's like that. Have you seen the video?
Yeah, I see the fucking video.
I hurt myself.
Yeah, what do you think? Would you just think you just fucking discovered the,
no,
the Johnny Cash because you saw a movie, Mija?
I didn't. First off,
Mira, listen, this
I grew
is,
up on Johnny
look
Cash.
At this. This is fucking rock and roll right here. I love this fucking guy right here. You know who this is? This is Iggy Pop. Right here. This is punk rock music. You don't know about punk rock music. This is the beginning of punk rock, and this is in the 60s. It's good music for the 60s. Iggy Pop is from Miami, too. He lives in Miami. I'm a ski-walking cheetah with a hat full of napalm. See? Rock and roll is music that makes you want to snort cocaine. That's how you know it's rock and roll. If it doesn't make you want to go and do 27 lines off some hooker's tits, it's not rock and roll. It's not. That's not rock and roll. I don't care if it has a distorted guitar. I don't care if the guy has long hair and there's a drummer in it. That's not fucking rock and roll.
But what was rock and
roll?
Rock
and roll makes you want to snort cocaine. Rock and roll in the 50s?
Little. Exactly.
Tutti frutti, ah Rudy. Tutti frutti, ah Rudy. That shit makes you want to snort cocaine.
My gosh.
I sold Cash boots at Nordstrom. He was like 6'4", coolest, cool, horny, really? That's amazing. That's a great story, man. Pepe, no soy marihuanera, pero mándame saludos anyway. Susanita, claro que te voy a mandar saludos. Belleza, claro, all day. And we're celebrating aquí marihuana fucking, the marihuana fucking Nochebuena here. But yeah, and talking about all kinds of shit because I'm so high, I'm jumping topics all over the place. Too bad it's not fucking Adderall fucking Nochebuena because we would probably be more on topic. But Lily, esto, hablando, siguiendo hablando esto, la conversación de la marihuana. Do you what do you think about the new strains of marijuana? Do you smoke weed or have you?
I mean, I used to smoke weed. I think
I'm not a, you know, I smoke like here because I like to chill when I do the show and relax a little bit, and I need to calm down a little bit when I do this show. So believe me, I'm taking fucking wax to the face, you know, almost an ounce a show, okay? And you know, that's how, this is about how calm, this is about as calm as I get. But I've never been a big fan, you know, in the past of this shit. This is something new for me that I just recently started to like.
I mean, I see why people like it. It's just, I don't like, I like to be clear-headed.
I like uppers.
I like to be clear-headed. I don't like to, like, have anything, like, I don't know. It just, it gives, I'm not paranoid. I just get really antsy. And it's just, I mean, when I was younger, I used to smoke. But now as I've gotten older, I don't really see the use of it, you know?
I think I like uppers. I think that anything, like, you know, back in the 60s.
Like, fucking...
not amphetamine, like methamphetamine. Don't confuse it because now we have meth. It's not the same thing. But they used to do pills like Dexedrine and...
What's that one from Wolf of Wall Street?
The one they used in Wolf of... Which what? The Quaaludes?
Quaaludes.
Yeah, but that's totally...
That's a downer?
That's
don't know. I wasn't around.
You know what a Quaalude is? A Quaalude is like... Is comparable to a Xanax, kind of.
Oh, okay.
Just the Xanax doesn't have the euphoric feeling that the Quaaludes. Quaaludes are fucking amazing, man. Those are good shit. That was good fucking shit. I remember those motherfuckers like very vividly. Mm-hmm. Those good shit. You know what that shit? It was great. You know what that reminds me of? Like today would be good shit that you can't find anywhere anymore.
What?
Is like that lean purple activist lean shit.
Oh, you like?
I tried it a couple of times with some fucking ganguero friends of mine. They hooked it up with some lean. You know, it's basically like taking a fucking Percocet.
People die from that.
Yeah, because it's an opiate and they overdo it.
Bro.
Yeah, but it's an opiate. That's, you don't die. You don't overdose on opiates. You know that, right?
So how do you die?
You die. Like, there's like, okay, like, I'll give you an example. Like, there's women, okay, that have been taking painkillers, like, for chronic pain forever.
Yeah.
That if you took the dose of painkiller that they take, you'd fucking go into a coma. But what kills you in the pain when you take opiates isn't an overdose of the shit that kills you. You stop, your body shuts down, like your respiratory system. It's a very fucking like chill death, really. Oh. You forget to breathe and you die.
Sounds awesome. Sounds
it's kind of
pleasant.
It's very, it's the heroin. You know what, I'm sure, it's a heroin chic,
you know,
way
to
die.
Not taking heroin and living.
Meth is an upper, yes, but meth is a synthetic upper that's way too fucking, like, meth is like amphetamines on steroids, but Dexedrine, which is something that they give to people that are, like, looking to suppress their appetites or that are looking for a little more energy, you know? Like, they give that shit to fucking pilots and shit in the military, I heard.
Really?
You know, they used to give that shit. Fuck it.
I mean, they don't do that now, do they?
Escucha, Alfredito. Oye, you remember Blue Dolphins? Yeah, of course I remember fucking Blue Dolphins, man. Que pinga. Of course. Yeah, Dexedrine is like a fucking amphetamine, you know? It's basically like, I guess like Adderall in a way. Because Adderall is amphetamine.
Is it still
salts.
Around?
Dexedrine? Yeah, absolutely. A lot of people, they used to call Dexedrine in the like 60s and the 50s. If you watch the show Mad Men, it was like the housewife's... buddy or some shit.
Oh yeah, like I mean, I know that
they used to sell that shit over the fucking counter.
Like cocaine and heroin used to be.
I mean, but yeah, but that's a long ass fucking time ago. I mean, that's, you're talking about the fucking like 1910,
like
the 50s. Nah, cocaine wasn't legal in the fucking 50s. That shit was illegal by 1920. Mija, get the fuck out of here.
No.
I wish they used to put cocaine in the cocaine Coca Cola.
Oh really?
Yeah, it was like Coca Cola was like Four Loko back in the fucking 20s. Yeah, that's good shit. And that's what kind of fucking, what's happened, you know, what amphetamines have, what methamphetamine has done to old, like, you know, mild amphetamines from the, like, 50s and 60s, is what marijuana, to me, has become today. Because I'm not, this is new shit to me. Like, I'm sorry to say, personally, and maybe I sound like a little bit of a pussy man right here, but Toda la marihuana esta de fucking California y Colorado, these fucking strains of like genetic weed that people create, these concoctions they create, and they're fucking... Oye, yo me fumé una vez, la última vez que yo me fumé un fucking white boy con una socia mía que vino aquí a fumarse un tabacón conmigo.
Yeah.
Okay? She brought some shit that was so fucking strong. I didn't touch it again until Nino gave me this shit. It was so fucking strong, I got paranoid. I started seeing shit, and I was... I'm not embarrassed to say it. I ended up on my shower in the fetal position, llorando porque estaba viendo la cara de Jesús, thinking that I was going fucking crazy.
Yeah, that's the thing. People don't...
That shit fucked me the fuck up.
You can't just smoke any type of, like, weed. You have to, like... You have to build up your tolerance. It's like any, like, drug. You can't just go, like... You can't just do a whole eight ball, like,
but
the
who
first
the
time.
Like, does the weed today, like, when you're used to it, do... Is that the effect that it had on me, okay?
I know the effect wears off. Like, you don't...
That effect
time.
That it had on me, that it fucking knocked me on my ass. And I was hallucinating. I was seeing shit. I was so fucking paranoid.
Uh-huh.
Like, paranoid to the point of fucking insanity. It was bad. I thought I was losing my mind, really.
Yeah.
That... You know, it freaked me the fuck out. I was a panic. I went to a panic attack. Like, is this what the fuck these people that smoke this shit on a regular for you?
No,
this is what gets you high now?
I just think that was too strong of a weed for you to be smoking. I just think you had a bad reaction. Maybe if you tried...
It was called Granddaddy Perp.
Yeah, maybe if you tried something like regular, like, mid-grade weed, you'd probably be fine. Like, you have to build it.
Because the girl that smoked me out that day, she was fine. And she was freaking out. She's like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
I'm sure she's somebody that...
But I mean, I go to Jamaica... Y fumo con los jamaiquinos.
Yeah,
and that shit does wonders. Like, I laugh. It's funny. I get
weed.
Hungry.
Well, they don't really, like, they grow, like, outdoor, like, weed, like, wild weed. Like, it just grows. Like, they don't fucking do anything to it chemically or anything. Like,
so, yeah, but that's what weed is supposed to feel like. It's supposed to give you the giggles and fucking get you a little hungry and make you feel good. All right, shout out to you, David Fleitas from Wicked Vapor. Que vuelta, mi socio. Happy 420. Aquí estamos en el chat de la marihuana, la flaca y the pussy. But I mean, if you're just introducing yourself into the world of smoking marijuana, Lily, and you smoke some old, like, some of this strong shit, how the fuck do you make this a habit?
You
gotta like it initially, and that's not a pleasant experience.
You don't start with the fucking... You don't start with the super high grade stuff. You build up your tolerance, like.
But does anybody even sell regs nowadays?
Yeah.
Who sells regular?
I don't
weed?
Know. I don't smoke weed, so you could find somebody that smokes, really sells regs.
I don't think I've heard anyone tell me that the minimum that you can buy now in the 90s was the highest grade shit you could buy. It was called chronic.
Well, I smoked regs a lot when I was younger, so.
I mean, how do you know it was regs?
Because I know it looked like regs. It was shitty. It was shitty weed. Shitty, like...
But why was it shitty? Because it only gave you fucking the giggles and get you and smile and the fucking dance?
The high wasn't what I was used to compared to, like, when I would smoke better quality weed.
Because this shit doesn't fuck around, man. This fucking new concoction science experiment that they're making, this shit is fucking... I'm not cool with that shit. Even though this fucking whack shit that Nino got me on is pretty fucking strong, to be honest with you.
I mean, but you seem to be taking well to it.
Yeah, because, you know, I don't know. Maybe it's because I'm naturally amplified. Because
it's not that strong.
Don't smoke that shit. It gives you a headache. No me diga, Carlos. No. It does me. It does okay for me. Like, I haven't had a problem with it. I don't like I smoke, and I don't smoke out of those contraptions that people smoke out of. Coño, Marquito vino aquí una vez with a fucking with a small briefcase that carried a pipe glass, a fucking blowtorch, his shit, all this shit. I was like, nigga,
that's like he's smoking dab.
No, it looked like he was smoking crack.
Yeah, it's a fucking like a.
And I was concerned. I'm like, people, are you freebasing him? Que vuelta, oye, está malo la cosa. He's like, no, this is how you smoke weed now. I was like, no me diga, mi brother. All day, mi socio, David. ¿Qué, mama? Ya vas a empezar con la marihuana.
I gotta go.
Dale para la pinga. Yo estoy aquí hablando con mi gente de la marihuana y cogiendo nota.
Everybody, see you all tomorrow. I'm gonna go.
You think I started the show without you, mija? All you've been is a distraction all day. That's all we've been talking about. Your pussy. Or you're being a pussy.
Okay.
You being a little pussy.
I'll let you get back to that. Un abrazo.
Un abrazo. Mira, mira, tú quieres oír rock and roll, mija. Mira, escucha esto. Mira. Esto es Alex in Chain. This doesn't make you want to do cocaine. This makes you want to do a lot of heroin and be depressed about war.
That's what I need to hear.
That's good mellow out music for to close out the show. Mi gente, los quiero y me quedo corto. Aquí los dejo con a little Alice in Chains on 420. Like always, please, follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/Pepe Billete. Go on Twitter at Pepe Billete. Instagram, Pepe Billete, VPLP. And please give us a 5-star rating on the App Store. Lo quiero con cojones. Hasta me quiero con tu. Vaya, mi gente. Y ya tú sabes, disfruta la noche buena de los marihuaneros. Hasta mañana. Vine para atrás para darle un shout out a los Navarrete Brothers, que siempre están aquí en el chat hablando pinga y diciendo what's up, and I never say anything. Shout out to the Navarrete Brothers. Dale, mi brother, los quiero y me quedo con tú también. Keep enjoying the high music. Hasta mañana.